Have you ever asked yourself why a certain song is released and it spreads like wildfire? Ever asked why a few artists are controlling the music industry? Could it be because they are extra talented? Is it because they have a lot of money to pay for power play? Or are there artists who actually exchange sex for promotions?
And I'm standing on the front line.
The abuse of sex and drugs in the entertainment industry seems to be a global common problem. Whitney Houston, heralded for her majestic voice, left a gaping hole in the heart of the music industry due to drugs. In 2000, Whitney's bag was seized in Hawaii Airport after security found 15.2 grams of marijuana in the singer's handbag. She was charged, and later the charges were dropped. Whitney underlined that she was not shooting heroin, but listed drugs she took, which include alcohol, marijuana, cocaine and pills, as option. In 2012, Whitney's body was found in a bathtub, and rumors surrounding her death signaled the possibility of an overdose of prescription drugs. Houston had battled with drug and alcohol abuse for years. The multi-talented and charismatic performer Michael Jackson may be gone to live on in a digitally recorded afterlife, but it's suspected that the death of Michael Jackson was caused in large part by his addiction to prescription medication. And the world lost the king of pop. Sex and drug abuse has also been mentioned as key reasons why the one-stop artists hit their low moments in the music industry. Here in Uganda, the likes of Maddox Sematimba and Red Banton, though talented, have failed to flourish their music career due to alcohol and drug abuse. With very many artists in the music industry, a local artist has to do anything possible to rise through the ranks. Most artists do take drugs to ably pull off performances, while some believe that taking marijuana makes the voice stronger. However, music producers say that a voice can be achieved by undertaking training and coaching.
If your voice isn't good, however, even if you take a jerrycan of spirits, it will never clear up. Like, this client came in the studio and we were supposed to do a recording. The session was running for like 3 hours. Then the first 30 minutes, he went to the booth as he was recording. Maybe he felt he wasn't doing well. He went out. I didn't know he had gone to take some spirits. And by the time I looked for him to come back, I found him. He could not raise up. I thought, this guy is dead. Oh, my God. I had to call an ambulance to take him away.
And that's why there's a saying, in life there are no shortcuts, whether you like it or not. First and foremost, are you ready to be a big superstar?
I don't even accept this idea of Omubanda Waka Waka. I don't. How do the Katikiro, because when you call yourself that, the Kabaka may not say, no, I disown you. But the Katikiro should be knowing that young men, young girls are aware that this man takes drugs and he's so close to the king. Therefore, the best way to get to the king is by taking drugs. Excuse me, I disagree with that.
Uganda's industry has been ruled by a few top artists, and it is very complicated now for a new artist, however talented, to share the cake. The question is why?
The other guys set a very solid foundation, and probably that's why they are still here, and they'll probably still be here for the next 20, 50 years.
They could be the best. Or it's because they know the game, they know how to control the game. They have the money, they rule the industry. They know where to go after studio, they know how to play around it.
Not only here, not only in the music industry. When you are there, when you get there, you don't go easily. Look at the football teams. the English Premier League has been ruled by Manchester United, Arsenal, Chelsea and Liverpool for over 40 years. Same teams, year every year, year in, year out.
Uganda's music industry still lacks clear management structures. The few artists who have managers, once they get famous, cease noticing the roles of a manager.
The fame gets over their heads. You get the point. I'm telling you right now, there are so many top artists who are going abroad alone. They're leaving their managers here. They don't respect their managers. You get the point. Now, if you don't respect your manager, then why did you hire him or her to be your manager?
Another common way of easily getting noticed is by an artist paying or bribing the different media houses for power play. However, this seems not to be sustainable, especially if the artist is not producing very good music.
I think much as we as Ugandans, yes, we do have to support our artists also have to step up to the plate and deliver quality that we're going to want to listen to and going to want to play. I can't just play a song just because I'm Ugandan and patriotic. If it's not good, I'm not going to want to listen to it.
It happens, and I feel sorry for, if you don't oil the machine, it won't work.
So how can an artist break through the ranks without having to pay for power play?
It is true, some people get money out of them. But why do you have to pay for your song to be played? This is a big question mark. You have to bribe your way to get the song to be played because it's not nice.
It is very common these days that the young artists have resorted to using almost naked girls in the videos to capture attention from the audience. Mariam Dagire says these young artists are copying foreign video concepts which have affected African values.
It's not good, it's bad. Morally, Africans, we're not supposed to go nude. Africans, we're supposed to be clothed. Yeah? So our culture does not allow us to do that thing. I don't know where they're getting this. From Hollywood, maybe. From the West. They think that being naked is... But when you're singing, it's the voice that people want to listen to. It's not the thighs.
It feels bad. At times, these video producers, they fail to interpret our melodies. It feels bad. And another thing, why do you have to be nude? I think if you can't watch your video with your mama or with your daughter or your son, just don't do it.
Worse still, some artists have had to offer sex to either their managers, media personalities or promoters to have their music heard by the masses. The relevant players admit this is happening a lot.
I call that cheap. Why would you offer your body for just a song that will hit for 3 months? Like I told you, just for an advert song, you get... The song runs for 4 minutes and then you give your body to a producer in terms of,
What is your game plan? How do you want to get to the top? Do you have a strategy? Are you going to use sex? Do you know the dangers? Do you know the implications? Will you be earning that commanding that same respect? There's you being a big superstar, but when you're not commanding any respect.
The above seem to explain why most Ugandan artists have become famous for just one song and they are never heard again. The pioneers of the industry suggest that workshops should be held to mentor the young artists.